I'm like, oh God, oh, oh my God. Bitch, I run the game, y'all just commentate from the side. What up, guys? It's your girl, KCK, here, and I told you I'm playing Big Brother Season 20, Episode 34, just there. So let's dive right into this recap. Basically, the whole episode was basically the BB Comics, which is a classic game everybody loves because you don't see the comic. As much as in Pretty and Next They Were, I think the comics were last year a little bit better, but like, I feel like they just weren't really, they were nice to look at. My favorite of the comics, like, Pretty looking wise, I think the Winston thing, the twin thing, I thought that was funny. Like, really thought this dude is a twin. And I like Tyler's, I thought Sam was nice. You know, they're all good comics, but you know, you have your favorites. But I personally think the one classic is a little bit better. So, basically, this whole episode with DeVito, as you saw, Casey killed DeVito. She's like, the idea is to go back only once, not twice. Basically, Casey destroyed this competition in 2 minutes. Like, I keep saying this in my recap, but yo, I feel like Casey is in the running to win this competition, and I'm excited for Casey. I really am. Basically, so now that the episode is out of the way, because we're on the final, and obviously Thursday was, which is today. This will be up before Thursday eviction, before the episode airs tonight. I think it's on. And it's a double elimination, so I will talk more about that a little bit later. But as of right now, going on in the house right now. So obviously, it's set in stone. Sam and Haley are on the block. Haley is going home. Haley is going to the jury, but she won't be alone for long because somebody else will tag along the same day. So let's basically see in the house. JC likes to run his mouth a lot, and I don't know why he feels the need to tell. We already knew this. JC wants Anta out of the house. Brett wants to make a big move because he realized he's like at the end of that, at the end of that group. And him and JC, even as they showed in the episode, they've gotten close. So it's like, they're telling each other this. JC, I don't know. The words come out of JC's mouth. It's like, dude, you don't tell people this. Like, why would you tell him you need to put Angela on the block? You know, and you've been saying it. Like, he's close with Angela. So why would you say Angela needs to go on the block with Casey? Angela needs to go home. Angela this, Angela that. Why would you keep saying that? Tyler relayed the message that basically, okay, so here's what happened. I can't remember exactly word for word, but Brett talked to Tyler saying that he thinks Angela and Casey should go on the block to go home. And I'm not sure if somebody pinpointed it. I think it might have been Angela. So Tyler tells Casey this. Casey's like, what, are you serious? Like, he's fine. The plan was to stick together final four. But if he wants to play dirty like that, we'll play like that. It's like he'll be the next one gone after Haley. And they tell Angela this and they're all at this point I'm just like, I love stuff blowing up people's faces. I'm like, yes, Brett, you're just digging yourself a bigger grave than you already have. I'm like, one, it was your own fault for talking to Tyler about this. Two, and then JC. They already thought he was, like, sketchy enough as it is, hanging with JC and letting these ideas flow. I mean, in Brett's scenario, I would be thinking that too. I'm even thinking it. Like, I'm like, okay, who's going to be the one to, like, mess this little four group up? I thought it was going to be down to Tyler, Angela, or Brett. I thought Casey was loyal to a T. Tyler, he's just been in a lot of final deals and groups with people. So I figure if he wins another HOE, he has to break some of those deals. Angela, and I said Angela because, I don't know. I feel like she might do something with Brett. I feel like Tyler and Casey are safe, but she might put Brett up. So they're just like, not here for it. They're like, all right, that's when it's like, we were going to target Sam and JC. Brett's going to be next. I'm like, yes, focus on Brett more. Leave Sam alone. I said, Sam survives another week. I'm happy for it. That's why I think Sam is good next week. And it's a double elimination too, so I don't know what it is. You know what? It needs to be like a luck thing, because I think true or false stuff, it's not Sam's suit. I think maybe a puzzle, but if it's a double elimination, it's them something quick. So they might do true or false. Something like, they might do true. They're going to target Brett during the double eviction, and I'm praying that happens. So I don't want Brett to win, if it means my people can sit. Because I only have 3 people left, and I still need them. I have my 5, I have 3 left. Basically, Brett and JC don't want Angela to win double eviction, and obviously, they don't want Brett or JC to win. I personally need Sam to win because that's not the way they're trying. But if
just by case Sam doesn't win, honestly, if it's, whatchamacallit, if Angela, Tyler, or Casey win, preferably Casey or Angela, no, I'm sorry, Casey can't even play. If it's Tyler or Angela, I feel like the best case for them would be to put JC and put Brett up. Put both of them sticky bitches up together. And then whoever wins the veto, that's who you take down. And then I guess, I have no choice, you gotta put Sam up. And then whoever goes home. So if you end up putting one up, it's just put both of them up. Yeah, so they're just reassuring. Haley's going out reassuring. She has people's vote. She's saying, like, I would rather you guys just tell me I'm going home rather than hear from Julie. And then to be blocked, just tell me up front. That's how I hate when people, it's like, it's set in stone. It's like, you realize like they're going to jury. That's what I understand that part about people when they do that. It's just, I'll be honest with you, I'm like, no, you're going home. It's like, they're going to jury. It's like, I don't understand that whole democracy of doing that when it's set in stone. So that's basically much it, guys. I want JC to go, and if JC doesn't go, I need Brett to go. And if JC or Brett want to go, I prefer JC to go. I don't care who the HOH, as long as it's not them two. And that is it for this recap, guys. I'm Keezy Cat, saying, see ya.